As cryptocurrencies continue to gain traction worldwide, the need for secure storage solutions has become paramount. Hardware wallets offer a robust and reliable method for safeguarding digital assets, providing an offline storage mechanism that protects private keys from online threats. This video explores the features and innovations of several leading hardware wallets from companies like SafePal, Trezor, Ledger, CipherRock, Tangent, Descend, and Keystone. In this video, we're going to delve into the specifics of the SafePal S1, Trezor Safe3, Ledger Nano X, CipherRock X1, Tangent, Descend Biometric Hardware Wallet, Descend All-in-One Card Wallet, and the Keystone 3 Pro. A detailed comparison will highlight the distinctions among these devices, offering a comprehensive understanding of their roles in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. The reasons why I chose these hardware wallets to talk about is because I actually own all of them, and that gives me enough information to get out a video and to give you all the necessary information. Now, the SafePal S1 stands out in the market for its balance between security and affordability. The hardware wallet offers a sleek design coupled with a comprehensive suite of security features. It operates with an air-gapped system, meaning it is completely offline and thus insulated from internet-based threats. The S1 employs multiple layers of security, including a self-destruct mechanism triggered by attempts at physical tampering and a unique EAL 5+ secure element. And that secure element is critical as it provides a robust environment for storing cryptographic keys and running security algorithms. Now, the wallet interacts with the SafePal app via encrypted QR codes, ensuring that the private keys never leave the device. And that method of interaction is particularly secure as it minimizes the risk of digital interception. Now, additionally, the SafePal S1 supports a wide array of cryptocurrencies, enhancing its versatility for users with diverse portfolios. Then moving on to Trezor, which is a pioneer in the field of hardware wallets. They offer several ones, and in this case I'm going to talk about the Trezor Safe3 as a continuation of its legacy of security and simplicity. Now, the Trezor Safe3 emphasizes user friendliness without compromising on security. Now, the Safe3 is built on open source software, which is a significant advantage for transparency and security, because open source software allows the community to inspect, audit, and improve the code, ensuring that vulnerabilities are identified and addressed promptly. Now, the device supports a broad range of cryptocurrencies and integrates seamlessly with various cryptocurrency management platforms. Now, one of the standout features of the Trezor Safe3 is its robust recovery system. Users can recover their wallets using a 12 to 24 word recovery seed phrase, which is a critical component in cases where the device is lost or damaged. Now, the seed phrase is generated offline, ensuring that it remains secure from online threats. Now, please know that the Trezor Safe5 is on the way, but since I don't own one personally, I left it out of this video. But I am, however, trying to fetch one from them, so be sure to subscribe so you won't miss out on that video. Now, let's move on to the next one, which is the Ledger Nano X, and it represents a sophisticated approach to hardware wallet design, combining robust security with enhanced usability. Now, the Nano X is Bluetooth enabled, allowing it to connect to mobile devices seamlessly. And that feature offers convenience without sacrificing security, as the Bluetooth communication is encrypted. The Nano X incorporates a certified secure element, providing a fortified environment for storing private keys. And this secure element is crucial for protecting against both physical and digital attacks. Now, furthermore, the Ledger Nano X supports over 1800 cryptocurrencies, making it one of the most versatile hardware wallets available. And the Ledger Live app enhances the functionality of the Nano X by enabling users to manage their portfolios, stake assets, and even access decentralized applications directly from the wallet. This integration provides a comprehensive ecosystem for managing and interacting with cryptocurrencies. Now, please know that there have been some issues in the past with connecting the Ledger to dApps, and then hacks have happened. So personally, every hardware wallet that I use, I just use it for storage. I don't use it to connect to a dApp or to connect it to a website. I just want it to keep it safe and secure and have my crypto safe and secure and not use it as, let's say, a daily driver. All right. Let's move on to the next one, and the next one is the CipherRock X1. It introduces an innovative approach to hardware wallet security by employing a distributed architecture. Now, the X1 system includes four separate devices, each holding a fragment of the user's private key. And that method, known as Shamir's secret sharing, ensures that the private key is never fully present on a single device. Consequently, the risk of key compromise is significantly reduced. Now, in addition to its unique key management system, the CipherRock X1 does not require a seed phrase for recovery. Instead, Users can recover their wallets by reassembling the key fragments from the devices. And this approach simplifies the recovery process while maintaining a high level of security. Now, the CipherRock X1 supports multiple cryptocurrencies and integrates with existing cryptocurrency management platforms. Its focus on decentralizing key storage and management sets it apart from traditional hardware wallets. Now, the next one is Tangem, and they take a unique approach to hardware wallets by utilizing smart card technology. Now, Tangem wallets resemble traditional credit cards, offering familiar and convenient form factors. Now, each Tangem card contains an EAL6 Plus certified secure element, providing a high level of security for storing private keys. Now, Tangem wallets are designed for simplicity and ease of use. Users can initiate transactions by just simply tapping the card on a mobile device with NFC capabilities. And this contactless interaction streamlines the process of managing and spending cryptocurrencies. Now, one of the notable advantages of Tangem wallets is their cost effectiveness, because they are relatively inexpensive compared to other hardware wallets, making them accessible to a broader audience. Now, Tangem's focus on accessibility and ease of use positions it as an attractive option for newcomers to the world of cryptocurrencies. And then if we look at Descent, their biometric hardware wallet introduces a biometric security as a key feature. And that wallet incorporates a fingerprint sensor, adding an additional layer of protection by ensuring that only the authorized user can access the wallet. Now, biometric authentication simplifies the process of unlocking the wallet while maintaining robust security. And the Descent biometric hardware wallet supports a wide range of cryptocurrencies and offers a user-friendly interface. It connects to mobile devices via Bluetooth, providing a convenient way to manage and transact cryptocurrencies on the go. And the wallet also includes a secure element for safeguarding private keys and executing cryptographic operations. Now, they have another product, and that product is their all-in-one card wallet. And that combines the form factor of a smart card with the functionality of a hardware wallet. And that wallet provides a compact and portable solution for storing and managing cryptocurrencies. Like the Tangem wallet, it leverages smart card technology and NFC for secure transactions. And the all-in-one card wallet supports multiple cryptocurrencies and integrates with the Descent mobile app for seamless management. And its compact design and ease of use make it a convenient option for everyday cryptocurrency transactions. Now, if you look at the next one, which is the Keystone 3 Pro, that's a hardware wallet known for its robust security features and user-friendly design. It employs a multi-layered security approach, including a secure element and air-gapped operation, ensuring that private keys remain offline and safe from online threats. Now, the Keystone 3 Pro features a large touchscreen for easy navigation and transaction verification. It supports a wide range of cryptocurrencies and integrates with various cryptocurrency management platforms. Now, the wallet also includes a recovery system using a 12 to 24 word recovery seed phrase generated offline for enhanced security. And when we compare these hardware wallets, several key differences emerge. So the SafePal S1 and Trezor S3 prioritize offline security with air-gapped systems and open source software. Now, the Ledger Nano X and the Descent biometric hardware wallet introduce enhanced usability with Bluetooth connectivity and biometric authentication, catering to users who prioritize convenience alongside security. Now, the CipherRock X1 distributed key management system offers a unique approach to mitigating key compromise risks, distinguishing it from traditional hardware wallets. Now, Tangem and the Descent all-in-one card wallet focus on accessibility and simplicity, offering cost-effective solutions with smart card technology. Now, the Keystone 3 Pro stands out for its multi-layered security approach, a large touchscreen enhancing user experience. So, cryptocurrency hardware wallets play an important role in safeguarding digital assets, offering a range of features to cater to different security and usability preferences. The SafePal S1, Trezor S3, Ledger Nano X, CipherRock X1, Tangem and Descent Biometric and All-in-One Card Wallet each bring unique strengths to the table. Now, I actually own all of them, as I said before, and I have discount codes to each and every one of these hardware wallets in the description down below. I also use all of them for the simple reason that I believe that different hardware wallets can have different purposes. If you look at the SafePal and Ledger one, these need to be charged just like the Descent biometric hardware wallet. But the Tangem card and the Descent all-in-one card wallet do not have to be charged and can always be used. Now, the Ledger needs to be connected to the computer, and the CipherRock X1 needs its thumbstick. And the Keystone 3 Pro offers the biggest display, making it convenient to use, but their app is definitely lacking. Now, I use the Keystone 3 Pro to secure one of my software wallets, for instance. Now, one app or suite looks better than the other, but SafePal, for instance, allows you to own a software and a hot wallet simultaneously in the app. Now, just how the Descent app on your phone allows you to switch between the biometric card and app wallet. Now, having your crypto stored on multiple devices allows you to use them differently. One can be your daily driver, while the other one can be used for long-term storage. And that's exactly how I use my HAWA wallets. Now, if you want to learn more about the wallets individually, please be sure to check out my dedicated videos by going to my HAWA wallet playlist. So in short, the choice of a hardware wallet ultimately depends on individual needs and priorities. Whether it's the innovative key management of the CipherKX One, the biometric security of Descent, or the extensive cryptocurrency support of Ledger Nano X, users have a plethora of options to ensure the safety and accessibility of their digital assets. Now, as the cryptocurrency landscape continues to evolve, hardware wallets will remain a critical component in the pursuit of secure and user-friendly storage solutions. That's it for now, and I'll see you guys next time. Doei!